All right, guys, welcome back into RollPlay Solum. I'm going to hour number 3 here for whatever week this is. I didn't look that up, so I think it's 27. I want to say it's 27. Hopefully,
I'm
right.
We might be past that.
We might be 28. We might have moved on into the 8s. But regardless, I need to roll for initiative, and whoever goes first needs to go first.
Leia also. Oh, you rolled initiative, Leia. Zanzel rolls the initiatives.
Yeah, let me just look over. What is the spell? 2, 5. All right, 5.
When I said they can take gaseous form or the form of wolf, I lied. It's gaseous form or the form of a bat. I think I was thinking of Eastern vampires. They can take wolf form, maybe. No? Okay, I don't know where the wolf came from. That's a lie. It's just a full-fledged lie. Zanzel.
I go first?
Yes.
I cast Ray of Enfeeblement.
Ooh.
Nice.
So just save her spell and I'll tell you what it does.
Maybe it doesn't affect.
It says humanoid demihumans and humanoids of a man size less or reduce. Oh. That's just for their. You might have to look this up.
Hmm.
I feel like it would affect him.
Yeah, that should affect a vampire. Let's give him a saving throw versus Sparrow. He rolls a failure.
So, yay! Humans, demi-humans, and humanoids of man size or less are reduced to an effective strength of 5, losing all strength bonuses and suffering an attack roll penalty of -2 and a -1 to damage. Other creatures suffer a penalty of -2 on attack rolls. Furthermore, they have a -1 penalty for each die of damage they inflict, but no damage roll can inflict less than 1 point of die damage. Your DM will determine any other effects appropriate for the affected creature. If the target creature makes its saving throw, the spell has no effect, blah, blah, blah. Spell has no effect, combat bonus to magical items, and those conferring increased strengths functions normally. That's all I got.
The vampire goes next and kind of like pulls his cloak around his face and gives out a hiss and then goes poof and turns into this mist that starts flowing down the hallway headed for the front door.
Can I still use my attack towards that?
Are we free action right now?
Yeah, he can. What's the mist movement speed?
Is he moving past us?
No, he's moving perpendicular to you. Or to the line that you and him form. So you guys are in the parlor, and he's headed for the front door.
So, like, since I had already done my initiative, can I still aim at that?
Sure. Yes, go ahead. I'm going to say he can turn into mist and he can't make it very far, although the exact rules are kind of spotty here. So make your... It's what? He has to make a save or spell, or... You cast Flaming Sphere, right?
Yeah.
All right, so he has to make a save or spell, and he passes, so he takes half damage.
Oh, right? So he would take it. Yeah, it's half damage, you're right.
Okay, he takes 1 point of damage.
What?
You should roll. I'm sorry. Give me a d4.
Yeah.
I should not roll that for you.
What? Neil, this could be 2.
2d4, but he only takes half, so 2d4 divided by 2.
I feel like this spell is way too weak. That makes no sense.
It's a second level spell. Yeah, it's not a very strong one.
2d4, like, the fire spell I had at level 1 was better than this.
No, it's not. D3 plus 2 is less than 2d4. Also, that only lasts for a short bit. Flaming Sphere rolls around forever and ever and ever and ever.
D4. 2.
2 damage.
And can I make the sphere follow him and burn him?
Totally.
Like the mist?
Yeah, also, we'll read the spell. Yeah.
Well, that's what I thought it would do, but I wanted to confirm with you. It's why I'm saying that. Alright, well, the fire is following the bat.
The mist. He's not a bat.
The mist.
And then we come to Tariq / Victarion.
Okay, so we...
Tariq, why are you trying to attack my friend? I run towards him to grab him.
Do we have a roll-off at 12s, or...?
No, your actions happen simultaneously. Like, he gets to you as you're doing whatever it is that you're doing.
So you get your first attack, but your second and third won't.
Yeah. Well, the vampire has moved out of your attack range already. He has...
Should he get an attack of opportunity as he turns into a mist, though, and his magical blade can still hurt it?
your magic blade passes through the mist. Like it's easy to hit the mist and it passes through doing no harm for your attack of opportunity.
Okay. So if I realize that no harm can be done via the mist. I don't know. I'll wrestle with Victorian.
Excellent.
You're charmed, you fool!
I don't know what that means. I'm going to go try to tackle him, basically.
I will resist.
17 versus a 16.
I'm just making an attack roll against AC 10 to try and tackle Tariki.
Well, this is to get into
so
grapple,
it's just my melee adjust, though, right?
Just your melee adjust, yeah.
Which is 6.
Yeah.
25. I don't really roll lower than a 19 these days.
All right. Give me opposed strength checks, you did the two of you. See if you can knock him to the ground.
I have 17 strength, I must warn you.
You better beat this.
You better beat a 20.
Is that Ryan 1 coming
in?
Boom. Just
we
barely.
Got it. We got it.
All right, Neil, tell us what happens. I ran into him.
Okay, you run into him and try and bring him down, but he keeps his feet, and now the two of you are kind of grappled together.
Why are you trying to hurt my friend that I can't remember his name?
He's not your friend.
You don't. It's not that he's your friend. And you don't remember his name. It's just you have a very good feeling about him, sort of thing.
He looks so respectable.
He's fantastic at first impressions.
This is the friendliest wrestling match in the corner.
Neil,
ever.
I don't want to backseat too hard, but Chad is saying a saving throw versus charm has to be made every other round under the effect of a charm spell.
I'm looking up the effects of charm spells and all that stuff.
Okay. That might be in newer editions because I know the old stuff was much more hardcore.
Why are we grappling naked and oiled like this? I don't understand.
I don't know.
It's greatly aroused.
It's so arousing, yes.
When did we begin to exercise this way?
I've become so vigorous, even my dead hand is coming to life.
Tariq, you should put the oil on him.
Wonderful.
Tariq, get oil. Put the oil in the fight.
I've grown bored of women. I yearn for your your pale penis.
Victorian, what is your intelligence, Victorian?
It is 13.
Oh, also, what the hell is your willpower? That's where you might know.
10?
No, you don't have, yeah. If it was high enough to get a magical defense adjust, that would have added to your save.
No, but my squirrel fucking soup, Neil, is usually excellent.
Right.
How do you speak 3 languages?
This charm person would not obey a suicide command, but he might believe the caster if it assured that the only chance to save the caster's life is for the person to hold back an onrushing red dragon just for a minute or two. Note that the spell does not endow the caster with linguistic capabilities beyond those who normally passes. Duration of the spell is a function of the charm person's intelligence and is tied to their saving throw. Spell may be broken and blah, 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 and the saving throw is checked on a periodic basis according to the creature's intelligence. If the caster harms or attempts to harm the charm person by some overt action, or if a dispel magic spell is successfully cast upon the charm person, the charm is broken. 2 charm spells at the same time, the DM decides what happens. So your intelligence is 13?
Yep.
So every 2 weeks, you get to make an extra saving throw.
Mark it in the calendar.
Yep. Let it be known. 2 weeks. 2 weeks.
All right, so this is day 1, Neil. So
Neil, can I make a intelligence check to see what happens or what the best way is to counteract this mist form of a vampire? Or can I just know with rolling that 33 the best ways?
Let's see. You know the mist form that the gaseous form that the vampires can take is pretty much like immune to physical attacks. You can't slash it. You can't stab it. Area things, like maybe if you set the mist has to go through fire, that might do some damage.
What about
fire?
What about on the mist? If I put fire on the mist, does that take
damage?
Yeah, that's what I'm doing.
Yeah, that's area damage on fire. That should affect it.
What?
I mean, not like a candle.
Is he going out into the open area?
Out to the front yard is where it looks like he's headed.
I'm going to follow him, and if I can, and you let me, I'm going to cast Fireball.
Okay.
JB, stop trying to outdo my fire spell, okay?
Hey, man, this is I've only got this.
Flaming Spear is lovely.
That's all
Thank
I've got.
Thank you very much. So Hell's I need to, 4 damage is going to take this beast down.
Do I have to make a roll like I did against that the encampment thing to put it like in the gas? Or can I just cast it?
No, so you chase... No.
No, it's for the Flaming Spear. It's so people know what it looks like.
There. That sphere does not need balls, okay?
Well, there's fire at the back.
Fire,
yeah. Right, Neil, get like your mind out of the gutter. If I can make it Please. Yellow and orange, I would.
I feel like this is a G-rated broadcast.
Yeah. All
right. Okay. If you can get outside... Well, I mean, so you start chasing the guy outside is basically what I'm hearing.
I am at half movement speed, but is he not at half movement speed in gaseous form?
Not in gaseous form, because he doesn't need his legs to move.
Because my leg was minor bleeding, and so, I think that was half movement.
Yeah, Leia, you're rolling the ball after him as fast as possible, right?
Yes.
Okay, and what does it say what speed the Flaming Sphere moves at?
30 feet per round or something.
Does that mean the building's catching on fire as well?
Well, this hallway, sir, the tapestries in this hallway have caught fire, and the rug on the floor has caught fire.
Great. 30 feet per round, yeah.
Okay. So the Flaming Sphere can roll more or less to the front door, but the mist is moving faster than the sphere.
Zanzel,
you start making for the front door. You can hobble yourself to it.
I get two-third movement, not half.
Okay.
I don't know if that makes a difference. Chat spamming two-third. And it was a...
It was a six
minor
against
bleeding.
One. Yeah. Chat claims lots of things.
That's also a small
weapon. Yeah, it is two-third movement.
Through a dagger. I don't know if that has any bearing on it.
No. Two-third movement is indeed correct.
Okay.
Leia, what are you doing with your Flaming Sphere before we deal with Zanzel?
I think I'm still trying to catch up to the guy.
Okay. Zanzel, the front door is currently closed, so your sphere like rolls into the front door and just like, and that whole area is on fire. Zanzel,
you're telling me it can't get out? It's just like
it can't open doors. What do you think it is? A velociraptor?
Yeah.
Could be. Well, now there's fire everywhere. We should get out of here. That's what I say.
Yeah,
I'm wrestling with Trigan. I'm like, the woman set fire to this house. I don't understand any of what we're doing here.
I feel like I'd be super aroused if I hadn't polished my sword just last night.
How is the door closed if Zanzel just went through it?
I didn't.
He didn't go through it. He's still in the parlor. He's heading for the door, but now there's a flaming sphere blocking the exit.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
Can I stop it?
Yeah, sure. You can dispel it.
Oh, well, then I dispel it.
Okay. Door, flaming sphere dispelled. Zanzel, you make it to the front door, throw it open. Tariq and Victarion are wrestling in the back, and you see this mist kind of like floating down the street, heading for the edge of town, heading east. You guys are already near the very eastern side
Isn't
of town.
It daytime?
It's like a wealthy No, it's nighttime.
It's nighttime. That's why I didn't
it's
sleep.
The very wealthy district of town, and there's lots of just big mansions kind of spread apart.
Are there people?
And it's heading down the street towards the wall.
Are there people in the street?
No, it's in the middle of the night. There's no one in the street.
Hold on. Let me look at the range of the spell real quick just to make sure. I don't want to just destroy a town. I mean, I kind of do, but 20-foot radius. How wide is the road?
The road is like 14 feet wide, but houses are pretty far set back from it. And there's lots of shrubberies in front. Again, it's a very lush, rich area. Pretend you're in Montecito or...
Shrubberies, did you say?
Yeah, I'm just...
It'll guard a gate.
I'm going to cast it on him. I've got a... I'm level 8, so I've got a 90-yard range on it.
Okay. Yeah, you can easily hit him with that range.
Okay. Do I... He save or spell for half damage?
I will roll the save or spell. Just roll the full damage. I'm looking up something else right now.
Is there a maximum here? Hold on. Oh, up to a max. Okay. 8d6. 27. Kind of bad.
Jesus Christ. saving throw versus spell. Okay. He takes a ton of damage.
So you fail.
I don't think
we can't tell one way or the other.
I don't think we're allowed to
usually
know.
Usually you tell us, Neil.
I'm level 7?
Yeah, but usually it's something very obvious, like a fireball is exploding and there's a person nearby and you can't tell if the person is being...
Hold on,
like,
I thought I was 8.
It's missed, you know, it's missed, and you guys, you're inside wrestling anyway.
Hold on, Neil, we might need to knock off that 6.
What do you mean?
We're having a fucking good time.
I might
here.
Be level 7.
How much XP? You might be level 7?
You're level 8.
I think you're level 7.
I'm level 7, yeah, level 8 is 90, so knock off that 6, 21.
21 damage. Okay. What the fuck is this? I'm looking for a very specific paragraph in here. Here we go. Okay. The mist just like gets blown apart, but it's not entirely gone. Like it still has some sort of form, but it looks like there's a little bit less mist than there was before. And it immediately starts wavering and goes off the path and starts going through some foliage and stuff.
Is it still within cast range?
Of fireball?
Hold on one second. If I can scroll up. Damn it, what are you doing? 60 yards plus... of 130 yards for magic missile?
Oh, totally.
Missile? Okay,
yes, but by the time that your next round comes along, it has gone through some bushes and stuff, and you no longer have line of sight to it.
Okay. Well, I walk back in after that's been done then.
Okay. And walk back in, and Tariq and Victarion are still like, "No, I like you, but you're my friend. Stop touching my other friend," and just like,
"No, we separate."
Is the house like on fire?
I was trying to stop him from hurting him, and I'm like, okay. "What's the? Why are we? What were you doing? Why were you trying to hurt him?"
I ignore that and run out.
Tariq, okay. He's gone. Get back here. We need to get everyone out of the house. It's burning. He's gone. We'll have to find him.
Some saving throws for the house to see how quickly it catches fire. Oh god, the house fails at saving throws really badly. Oh my god. Okay, the house is becoming a raging inferno at this point. The hallway that Victoria, Zanzel. Well, yeah, but think of an old wooden house with lots of carpets and tapestries, and then someone rolled a 3-foot fireball down a hallway. Like, this hallway is just like a raging inferno now.
It's been 2 minutes. I'm joking. Yeah, I'm joking. You're right. I'm joking.
Yeah. So, you guys, you cannot go out the front door anymore. The front door is... Well, you can, but it's in a raging inferno. You take some damage.
Hurry, we'll break figure this out later, but apparently this place is burning to all shit. Let's get out of here.
Yeah. Yeah. To the window, right here. On the wall. Right there.
I slam through the window with my shield first.
The glass shatters, and you do a roll out the other side. Leia comes out. Tariq comes out. Everyone escapes the house.
What about
just
the body
see,
of the woman?
A half dozen horsemen charging down the road towards the house. They dismount and go, Where's the dreaded beast? And oh my god, the house is on fire!
Well, hang on. It's not dreaded. It's actually a pretty decent... guy. He's really respectable. Dressed smartly. More than I can say for you. Where did he go, though? I'd want to talk to him.
He's, you know what? I think you...
I look at the guards, I'm like, do you know what you're hunting?
The kidnapper of Lady Delilah.
Yeah, okay. He's, you know, he's gone for the day. He had, he threw, like, some sort of, alcoholic thing with some torch, and there's tons of fire. You need to go make sure that that's all good down the road. There might be some houses on fire.
They look down the road and see like the bushes that are all kind of slightly singed, but they were all lush because it's, you know, this is a very wealthy area. They can pay gardeners to come and water all the plants, so nothing caught fire and spread.
Okay, and then do we get Lady Morrow? Fucking whatever her name is.
Her corpse is still inside the building, which is on fire.
Do you want to? Yeah. Do you care about this woman? Should we get her? I tell the guards, I'm like, her body's inside. You can go right through here, but we gotta go.
Her body?
Yeah. Yeah. The kidnapper. When we got in the building, the kidnapper stabbed her in the back, or I stabbed her somewhere. I don't know exactly where. She fell to the ground. There's blood everywhere. But you might want to go get her. She's kind of unconscious.
The horsemen, the dismounted horsemen, kind of look at the house on fire. She's already dead.
Well,
no,
I'm glad you care about her as much as I do. We got to go, guys.
I lean into Zanzel after this, and I say, thank you for covering for him. He's very misunderstood.
I know, I know. Your friend will... We will find your friend soon.
I hope so. You killed her.
He's not talking about that friend. He's talking about the vampire.
Oh, shit. She's going to die now, right?
Yes, welcome to 30 seconds ago.
Yeah. I was like, yeah, but I was like, I patched her. And then I'm like, oh, yeah.
Yep, so that she could burn alive.
Yeah.
Yep. Just wanted to make sure she would feel the burn.
I casted fire immunity on her before I left the house.
Oh,
so
good.
Good, good.
Don't worry about it.
So you guys, what do you do?
We need to, I'm just like, we got to go back, find the Duke, tell him what's going on. And,
I feel we'll very strange about everything.
Hey, Victorian, do you want to go to any particular place right now?
I'm with friends. I miss my other friend.
Do you know where your other friend is?
I don't. I have no idea.
Well, if he makes contact with you, let me know immediately. I'd love to meet this guy. Sounds very
strange. Anybody else want to make me not feel strange? Like explain things to me or...
Nope. Sorry you feel strange. You're anxious. Hey, man, it's a big city.
Come back in 2 weeks, I guess.
It's a big world out there. It's going to be real rough. I'm just talking you down.
Yeah.
We need to sleep.
Sleep is good. Yeah. Sleep is healthy.
Okay. You guys head back to the Duke's house. Debrief him on what happened. He seems... pretty pleased. Zanzel, how much do you tell people about the fireball you set off?
I don't tell anyone that occurred unless the Duke asked me himself. I do the same story of he threw alcohol with a torch.
Okay. The Duke nods as well. Is he dead? Did we kill him?
I don't believe so, sir. I believe he will return. And we need to sleep because our friend here has come under the same effect that your daughter was 2 nights ago or 3 nights ago. But we can fix that. We just need a couple hours.
He frowns and says, who will keep us safe if you sleep through the night?
I shall keep you safe, friend.
He can talk him down, apparently.
Can we trust him?
Yeah, I think so.
Of course you can trust me. I'm friends with everyone. I'm a great guy.
He kind of comes over and says, Victorian, I think my daughter was asking about the date you were going to go on tomorrow. Could you please go answer her questions?
Absolutely.
Thank you. And as soon as Victorian leaves the room, he says, but isn't he under the effect of the creature? Can we trust him to defend us?
Well, he won't particularly defend us, but he won't necessarily hurt us unless we're... It's very complicated. We need to go to sleep, and hopefully this guy doesn't strike again. With my 33, do I know ways of repelling this monster from entering a room? Is it the bullshit where they can't come into a room unless they're asked to?
Yes, they are not allowed into a house unless they've been invited in. The whole garlic thing or a holy symbol presented to them will drive them off but not actually damage them or hurt them, but just prevents them from getting any closer to it.
I asked the Duke. I'm just like, do you happen to have any garlic in the pantry, perhaps?
I believe our servants have much garlic.
You should put it everywhere. Sprinkle it everywhere. Eat a little bit. It might make your blood taste bad. I don't know. But put it everywhere, especially at our doorsteps. And do not welcome any man that you do not know into this castle.
I shall tell my servants to keep everyone at bay. And the servants go and grab a bunch of garlic and hang it all over the doors and windows of the daughter's room.
Make sure that all of your servants stay behind something and out of the way of entryways. I know this will open it up for more burglars and whatnot, but he can only get in if someone enters him or lets him. So if someone is charmed, then they will let him. You know what I'm saying?
So do not let my servants answer doors for the night.
Yes. Consider the castle on lockdown.
Okay. He nods and does so. Victorian, you get up to the girl's bedroom, and she's just kind of up there, terrified.
Lady, you are safe. There's been a big misunderstanding, but we still need to find the person responsible for this crime against you, and I feel like you and I should get more comfortable together so tomorrow we can pull off this whole in love thing.
You were so brave in there, Victorian.
Thank you. I think I'm a very brave man. Neil, I would like to get physically intimate with her. I would sit next to her and test the waters.
The waters are cold.
Jesus. I'll go in anyways. Let's just roll for now.
All right, okay. We're going to try.
No,
so you're
okay,
toeing the water. Oh, shit, that's frigid. Fuck, I just got a cannonball then.
If she's very obviously not receptive, then I'm not pushing anything, but I'm just being charming or trying to be.
She's seen enough action for the night and uses every excuse to try and get you out.
Yeah. I will be just outside the door making sure you're safe, m'lady.
Okay.
M'lady?
The night passes. Victorian, you stay up all night keeping guard?
Not all night. I probably would.
If possible, I find Victorian some time before I go to sleep. And fuck, there's no tape.
What is it, friend?
Would you mind spending the night in the cellar? I feel like your friend might want to visit you, and okay. That's not going to be good. We need to prepare a festival, a party for him. And if he sees you, he's going to try to get in. So perhaps you should spend the night in the cellar so he can't find you.
Absolutely, Zanzel. That's fine.
So
I could use some rest anyways. I stayed up late last night.
I want to put him somewhere underground that is not reachable by a window or anything like that, to where he is heavily underneath the ground or really high up with no windows in the room.
Sure. You put him in a cellar or something, and the night passes uneventfully.
Okay.
Morning comes as you break your fast. You hear that Lady Morrowhammer's house burned to the ground last night, the whole thing. That her corpse and the bones of what are expected to be two of her servants have been found in the wreckage, but the fire did not spread to any of the other buildings in the area.
All right, I'm messaging you spells. Hold on.
Julio.
Well, I guess if Leia is not going to do it, then I cast a spell magic on Victorian as soon as I wake up, and I memorize spells.
Well, any circumstances? I guess I am also not sleeping in all my things, right?
Well,
yeah.
I mean, you usually sleep with armor. I tell him to perhaps remove everything and go into
a
corner.
I trust you. Absolutely.
Yeah. I would not dispel any magical items on you.
Thank you. Cool.
Thank you for making that clear, because I was about to screw you. cool. The spell goes off. And Victorian, you come out of what seems to have been like a slight haze, remembering all the events of last night very clearly. You've only been charmed for like a couple of hours. And everything kind of crystallizes in your mind. You're like, holy shit, he was the vampire.
So I do know that I've been tricked. Like, I'm aware of that.
Yeah.
I'm just like, how do you feel about your friend?
Not a friend. It's bullshit.
All right.
And I just, things got weird afterwards. I know.
Some men have that hypnotic trance. I had it once when I was younger.
Let's kill that scumbag if we ever see him again, huh?
We'll do. We need to collect some holy water. We'll stop by the church. I have a plan.
Sounds good.
All right.
I'm much better prepared. Yeah. Ready.
All right. So there are the spells, and we wake up. Nothing's happened. No reports of anything, Neil.
The house burned to the ground. Three corpses were found inside. None of the other buildings were affected. Her house is pretty much just rubble at this point. Some of it is still smoldering. And that's what you got.
Okay. I informed the party. I'm like, I would like to go collect some holy water. I feel it might be in our best interest.
She'll come with you, friend. Absolutely.
So we go to find the cleric or the apostle or whoever it was that we spoke to prior.
Clem. Father Clem.
Yep. We find Father Clem and ask if he could bless some water for us.
Well, it takes two priests to create holy water. It's a create water spell and a bless spell cast simultaneously, but we have some on hand.
Great. I like churches. And I stick out my hand.
He chuckles and says, I've heard what's going on, but the Duke has kept me in the loop since we are close to one another, you could say. Passes you 5 vials of holy water and says, I hope this will be enough. If you need more, do not hesitate to ask.
Do you have any more? I'm not hesitating.
He passes you another 10.
Okay.
Is this enough?
How much is 15 vials? Is that like 15 quarts, 15 pints? What are we talking?
Well, each vial, I mean, it's like they're individual, like little square jars with a stopper in them that you would like unstop and splash or like throw to break on a person.
How much?
May I carry a few?
Yes, yeah. Yes, of course. Could I fill like my canteen or whatever I have my water in with it?
Sure.
Okay, that's what I do. How much does it take to fill that?
Just consider it filled. What do you mean by how much? Like what volume?
How many containers?
How many 15 vials of those 15 vials? Or I guess can you also fill this as well?
He just takes everyone back into the back room where they have an oaken barrel that looks very well embroidered. It's got like, not embroidered, but like there's all sorts of runes and symbols carved into it. And it looks quite pretty. And it is just filled to the top with water and says, this is where we draw our holy water from. We make it every so often.
Yes. And I just dip my thing in there and start filling it up.
I'm going to say I take 5, Neil.
Sure.
I have 5.
Okay, so I'll mark 10.
Each one weighs about a pound.
Okay.
Yeah.
10. Oh.
I mean, you have your water skin filled with water.
I give all of the vials to Victoria. You take 15.
I take 15?
Yeah, because I'm just using my...
I give 5 to Tariq, and I give 5 to Leah as well.
I'll take
so I keep 5.
Okay, everyone's got 5 except for Zanzel, who's got a water skin filled with it.
Yeah.
Yep.
And then we see the scene from Bordello of Blood, where you use super soakers with holy water to fight vampires.
No, we're not going that far, but I do have a plan. We need to find
this man. Do you still think the vampire is drawn to the girl? Should I go on my date? Try to draw him out?
Perhaps we should also find, typically vampires have a coffin that they will reside in.
This is true.
We should try to find that.
You might be more careful now, right?
Well, he's not out during the day, but the coffin is a great idea.
He will return to his coffin regardless.
So we should search the graveyard.
Perhaps. Well, I don't know. Yeah. It could be anywhere in town.
Let's ask the gravedigger if there's been any graves disturbed. Didn't he say they've been having issues with
people
disturbing?
Yes, we should try.
All right, let's go there now. Okay. On the way, I'd like to stop by and make sure Helen's okay as well.
Well, why would a vampire disturb a grave? They want a fresh corpse, probably, right? Oh, got it.
Neil, would they have their own coffin, or would he stay in any coffin?
They typically have, I mean, whatever you know from Hollywood, basically.
So they'd have their own. They wouldn't take
it.
Yeah, that's what your understanding is. It's an imperfect understanding, but
the other thing, according to Legends of Lore, he kept bringing the girl back to Morrowhammer's house, so maybe his coffin might have been there, but is the basement also destroyed, or is it below the rubble?
We should stop by the house.
Yeah, that's true. That's where we found him, right? So, yeah.
We should also go and make sure the Duke has a citywide decree for any odd things occurring. And make
dark
sure that
people.
We get that information. Yes.
Dark people that turn into mist.
Yep, that should be a big one.
Okay. Let's check out the house and then check out the graveyard in that order.
Agreed. Sure.
Okay, you go back to Lady Morrowhammer's house. Most of the wreckage is still smoldering, and there's piles of burnt beams. The stones of the fireplace are still in place, as well as like a couple of the other walls that were stone in the house. Like the kitchen is more or less stone. The ceiling collapsed in on it, but the walls of the kitchen were stone. The basement was led down from the kitchen, so there's all these stone walls, and the second story just collapsed into it. So there's this huge pile of wreckage that is still smoldering. It'll take you a few hours to dig it out. If you can get some more people, it'll take a couple of hours.
We ask for the manpower, I guess, right?
All right. Yeah, the Duke gives you all the manpower you need, and half the city guard is out on their day off coming with you to dig out the house.
So we go to work on excavating
it. Yeah. It takes you a few hours with all these men to like haul everything out and get the area cool enough to enter, but you find the door to the basement charred but still on its hinges.
Okay.
I
enter, assuming we can.
Yeah. Oh.
Once we enter there, I'd like to close the door, and then I'm going to cast Detect Undead.
So the whole party goes down inside?
I
go in.
I stay up top.
So Tariq goes in, Leia goes in, Victarion goes in, Zanzel stays outside?
Yes.
Okay. And Leia, you shut the door behind you when you enter.
Can people see me? If it, actually, it's just so that people don't see me. That was.
I mean, if... So do you shut the door or not?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, shut the door, shut. What are you using for a light source down in the basement? Because it's
dark. Yeah, that's a good question. So she shuts the door, and I go, Leia, what the fuck?
Oh, I open it back up.
All right, door's reopened. There's no light. Cool. And you cast Detect Undead?
Yeah.